Hello, everybody. This is Scott, and I'm going to tell you a little something about Miss April. As you can see, we have two distinct pictures of April. On the left, she appears to be a little scared and unsure of what's going on. And on the right, it looks like she's laughing at one of my jokes. Do you know what happened between these two pictures? A lot of fun and exercise. From left to right, she's been hanging out with Jax, Chauncey, and Kylo, and she's been having a blast. Matthew's philosophy is to reward the dogs with long runs and fun, as opposed to treats. Although with pups like Kylo, having treats on hand is almost a must if you want 90% of his attention. He's a stubborn little Bernedoodle with a huge appetite and a high sex drive, I might add, as you can see right here. Make love, not war, right? Speaking of war, I'm challenging all registered voters to personally help at least one non-registered voter get registered. This is a very important election coming up, so it's important that registered voters help and educate non-registered voters on what they need to do to get registered. And it's even more important that before, during, and after the election, we do what we can on a regular basis to help make the city a better place. So make your city proud. Vote. Now back to the program. In addition to all the social time that April has been getting these past 2 weeks, she's also been learning how to keep a good pace alongside the bike. Biking with dogs can be a lot of fun, but it can also be very dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. You could hurt yourself or your dog. Before attempting to ride your bike with a dog, make sure that you know how to walk your dog correctly first. If your dog is pulling you everywhere while you're on foot, it's gonna pull you everywhere while you're on that bike. Second, the dog has to respect and trust you. If your dog doesn't respect you as the leader, he's not gonna wanna stop when you say stop at an intersection, for example. Third, the dog must learn how to trust other dogs within reason. This means that you don't want your dog barking back at every other dog that barks at them. That would make for a very unpleasant and difficult ride. In this scene, we have Chauncey's first introduction to April. Matthew wanted to make sure that Chauncey could trust April. He knew that April would be okay with Chauncey from previously working with her. Chauncey can be a little skittish around new dogs, so he must be introduced to them very carefully and cautiously. He must also be able to trust the strange new dog before he opens up. Matthew will have certain dogs meet for the first time with a fence in between them. This is where Jax comes in at. He'll get the party started by barking at the dog on the other side of the fence to get them going. After several runs back and forth, the dogs will begin to get to know each other and become more comfortable. April's friends list continues to grow. She now has 3 new friends to play with, and she needs it. April is full of energy, and from what I heard, that girl can run fast and far. 3 miles at a steady pace is a warm-up for her. Tell you what, I've said enough for now. We'll have more updates on April and the rest of the pack very soon. Until then, check out some of our other videos, and don't forget to subscribe. If you have any questions, please email us at teamwoods247@gmail.com. Be safe and remember, a tired dog is a happy dog. You dig?
That was a good dog there. You know, he always has that face smash.
He's a goofball.